Welcome dear student, once again in my channel. Now, in today's lecture, we will discuss over the syllabus for semester 2nd of FY BSc Zoology, paper Animal Diversity 2nd. This Animal Diversity 2nd is for the semester 2nd and it is Z0 121, that is the number of this course or the paper, and it is Animal Diversity 2nd. It is for 2 credit and there will be 30 lecture of it, and the distribution of marks are 15 for internal, which include the assignment as well as the internal test, and 35 marks exam will be conducted by the university. Likewise, combinedly there will be 50 marks score for this Animal Diversity 2nd paper. Now we'll see the syllabus of Animal Diversity 2nd. If you remember, in Animal Diversity 1st, for semester 1st, we have studied the 4 different phylums, which are Protozoa, Porifera, Cnidaria, as well as Platyhelminths. Now the rest of the phyla from non-chordate are included in this Animal Diversity 2nd paper, and after the Platyhelminths, the next phylum is Aschelminth. So the first topic is of phylum Aschelminthes, which is commonly called as roundworm. In this topic, we have to study the introduction to phylum Aschelminthes, means the characters of the phyla, then salient features of the phyla, along with the classification of phylum Aschelminthes, which has the only one class, Nematoda, and we'll have to study 2 examples. One is Ascaris lumbricoides, which is a common roundworm, and the second is Eucheria bancrofti, which causes the disease elephantitis, which is also called as the Eucheria worms or filarial worm. So both are parasitic, endoparasitic. And the last bit from this phylum Aschelminthes is economic importance of class Nematoda. So this is about the phylum Aschelminthes and first topic. In the second topic, we'll discuss the next phylum after phylum Aschelminthes, and which is phylum Annelida. That is the individuals with annular rings. These are also the worms, but with the annular rings, in which we will see the introduction to phylum Annelida, in which the general character that we will discuss, then salient features of phylum Annelida, and afterwards we'll see the classification of phylum Annelida up to classes, with examples of following classes, and in which we will see or study the names of the examples are from the different classes, and the classes are class Polychaeta, example is Neris pelagica, which is also called as a Neris or sandworm, then Aphrodite aculeata, that is also called as a sea mouse. Then the second class is Oligochita, example is Berytema posthuma, which is also called as earthworm. Then the third class is Hirudinea, and the example is Hirudinaria granulosa, which is also called as the common cattle leech. Then the last bit from this phylum Annelida is economic importance of Annelida with reference to earthworms as friends of farmers and in their role in vermicomposting. So this is about the phylum Annelida. The next phylum after Annelida is phylum Arthropoda, which is the largest phylum in animal kingdom, in which we will see the introduction to phylum Arthropoda, then salient features of phylum Arthropoda. Afterwards, we'll see the classification of phylum Arthropoda with specific classes and mention examples, and we have to only mention the names of the individuals. Then we'll see the classes, class Crustacea, the example is Palamon, that is a prawn. Then Brachyura species, that is crab. Then class Chilopoda, and the example is Scolopendra, which is also called as centipede. Then class Diplopoda, and the example is Julus, which is also called as millipede. Then the next class is Insecta, Peritema americana. The next class is Insecta, Periplaneta americana, which is called as the American cockroach. Then Anopheles stephensi, which is nothing but the mosquito. Then class Arachnida, which includes the spiders, both species, that is a scorpion. Then we will see the mouth parts in insect, which includes mandibulate type, which are present in cockroach, piercing and sucking type, which are present in female Anopheles mosquito, then chewing and lapping type, which are present in honeybees. Then the next bit that we will see, economic importance of Arthropoda. Then useful insects, which include honeybee, lac insect, silkworm, and the last bit from this phylum, that is harmful insects, which include female Anopheles mosquito, red cotton bug, and rice weevil. So this is all about the phylum Arthropoda that we will see in detail. Afterwards, we'll move to the next phylum, that is phylum Mollusca, which is also a second largest phylum of kingdom Animalia as far as the number of different species are concerned, and it is the first phylum with the fossil record, or which is having the huge fossil record. In the phylum Mollusca, we will see the introduction to phylum Mollusca, salient features of phylum Mollusca, classification of phylum Mollusca with specific classes, with the examples and only the names of the examples that we have to study. Then in the classes, we will see the class Gastropoda, example is Pila globosa, which is called as an apple snail. Then class Pericypoda, example Lamellidens marginalis, which is commonly called as bivalve. Then class Polyplacopora, example Chiton, or chiton, then class Cephalopoda, example Octopus vulgaris, which is also called as the octopus, then Cephea officinalis, which is commonly called as a cuttlefish. And in the last bit, we will see the economic importance of Mollusca. So this is about the phylum Mollusca, and the last phylum of non-chordate, that is phylum Echinodermata, which is exclusively marine, in which we will see the introduction to phylum Echinodermata, salient features of phylum Echinodermata, classification of phylum Echinodermata with specific classes, and along with the examples, and only the names are to be expected. Then in the classification, we will see the four different classes, which includes the number first class Asteroidea, which includes the Asterius rubens or sea star, or it is also called as starfish. Then next class is class Holothuridea, which includes the Holothuria species, example is sea cucumber. And then next class is Echinoidea, which includes the Echinus esculentis, which is also called as sea urchins. And the last class that we have to study is class Crinoidea, which includes the sea lilies or feather stars. So this is about the remaining phylum of non-chordate that we have deal with in semester second. Then along with that, we have a type study, and in a type study we have to study Asterius rubens or sea star in detail from phylum Echinodermata. In the type study, we will see this Asterius rubens, and in this, under this heading, we will study the classification of Asterius along with its habitat, external morphology, digestive system, water vascular system, and anatomy and regeneration. Then in next bit of this topic, we will see the pedicellariae in echinoderms, which includes state, cross, volvate, tridactylus, and globigulars. So these are the types of pedicellariae we will see in detail in the next bit. Now in the last bit of this type study, we will see the economic importance of echinoderms. What are the economic importance of the echinoderms that we have to study? That is the last bit of the this animal diversity second paper. So that's all. This is all about the syllabus for semester second in first year BSc Zoology. So we will see one by one in detail, and if you are having any doubt, query regarding this syllabus, please feel free to share it with me. So I will try my best to solve all your doubts. Thank you very much for watching the video.